Hi everybody, welcome to the Scripted channel. Yesterday, on March 18th, NVIDIA did something extraordinary, something that has already become history. In a presentation of its groundbreaking AI chip processor called Blackwell, NVIDIA showed us why human coders are no longer needed. Last month, in one of our previous videos, we saw how big tech revenues were going up despite massive layoffs. Meta's revenue, for example, skyrocketed even though Meta let go 22% of its personnel. It felt like big tech no longer needed coders to grow revenue, to grow business. But one thing was unclear: how big tech companies, which by definition rely on coding, how big tech companies could grow without coders. Now we know how. Yesterday, NVIDIA gave us the answer.
And so we imagine that this is a completely new way of writing software.
I very much encourage you to go and watch the whole NVIDIA presentation. It is 2 hours long, but it will change the way you look not only at the future of AI or coding, but at the future of our entire civilization. The presentation is done by Jensen Huang, probably the most powerful visionary of our time. An immigrant and a dishwasher Dennis, he founded a company that is now worth more than Canada. Yes, you heard it right. Worth more than Canada. He's one of the fathers of AI. And we had a video about him just recently here in the AI chip war. So definitely go and watch his presentation. But here in this video, I want to explain to you what I think is the most important concept of his presentation, the most important for coders. The idea that reveals the future of coding. We will start with Jensen's speech. It will be 3 minutes long and it will start awkwardly, but you will see why.
People ask me, how did it start? What got you guys so excited? What was it that you saw that caused you to put it all in on this incredible idea? And it's this. Hang on a second. Guys, that was gonna be such a moment. That's what happens when you don't rehearse. This, as you know, was first contact. 2012, AlexNet. You put a cat into this computer and it comes out and it says, cat. And we said, oh my God, this is gonna change everything. You take 1 million numbers, you take 1 million numbers across three channels, RGB. These numbers make no sense to anybody. You put it into this software and it dimensionally reduces it. It reduces it from a million dimensions, it turns it into three letters, one vector, one number. And it's generalized. You could have the cat be different cats. And you could have it be the front of the cat and the back of the cat. And you look at this thing, you say, unbelievable. You mean any cats? Yeah, any cat. And it was able to recognize all these cats. And we realized how it did it. Systematically, structurally, it's scalable. How big can you make it? Well, how big do you want to make it? And so we imagine that this is a completely new way of writing software. And now today, as you know, you type in the word C-A-T, and what comes out is a cat. It went the other way. Am I right? Unbelievable. How is it possible? That's right. How is it possible you took three letters and you generated a million pixels from it and it made sense? Well, that's the miracle. And here we are, just literally 10 years later, where we recognize text, We recognize images. We recognize videos and sounds and images. Not only do we recognize them, we understand their meaning. We understand the meaning of the text. That's the reason why it can chat with you. It can summarize for you. It understands the text. It understood, not just recognizes the English, it understood the English. It doesn't just recognize the pixels, it understood the pixels. Anything you can digitize, so long as there's structure, we can probably learn some patterns from it. And if we can learn the patterns from it, we can understand its meaning. If we can understand its meaning, we might be able to generate it as well. And so therefore, the generative AI revolution is here.
And here's what this all means. We're going to need two examples. Previously, in the past, if we needed to have an image of that cat, we had to hire an artist or a photographer to do it. But now, in this time, all you need to do is just type C-A-T, cat, and the generative model will create an image for you, will generate an image of a cat. Question: can you see the code behind that cat, the code that generated that cat, that picture? Not really. Even if you look under the hood of that model, all you're going to see is just a bunch of numbers, the weights between different neurons of that model. And that's it. There is no code per se. There is no code in a traditional meaning, in the way how we get used to it. There are no lines of commands that has to be executed to create something. Not anymore. Another example. Second example, and the most important one. In the past, if we needed, let's say we needed a game, a computer game, let's say a snake game, we had to hire a coder who would write the code for us. That code, when executed, would create that game. And now, and that's what NVIDIA tells us, and now all you need to do is just to type in a generative model, type, I need a snake game. And the model will create a game for you. And here's the most important concept here. Model is not going to create the code that will create a game for you. The model itself will become a game. Just like it generated that cat. In exactly the same way, it will generate that game. Here, that's the most important concept. The core of what is going on. The model did not create the code that when run actually appears like a game. No, the model created the game itself, skipping the coding part, just like it did with the picture. You see? So it's not just the human coders that are no longer needed. It's the code itself is no longer needed.
And so we imagine that this is a completely new way of writing software.
The code is no longer needed. AI generative models, the neural networks, they have become the new programming language. This is the most important discovery of this decade, maybe even of this century. This is the foundation of the AI industrial revolution. And this is why last year big tech firms started to lay off coders. Because big tech already knew back then that the software will be created in a different way. It's not going to be code anymore. It's going to be a neural network, a generative model. New generative AI models will be software. The new programming language, that's what it is. And NVIDIA told them back then, this is why they started laying off people. And now, NVIDIA told us, a year later.
And so we imagine that this is a completely new way of writing software.
Programming languages like Python, Go, SQL, and the rest of them, they're no longer needed. They're relics, they're legacy. Human coders no longer needed. Coding is not a human profession anymore. And NVIDIA is already making these new generative models. They call it NIMs. NIMs are already replacing humans. So what will the human coders do then? Is this the end of the profession? Well, as I say, some doors are closing, other doors are opening. Ironically, in that same presentation, in that harbinger of the end of the human coding, so in that same presentation, NVIDIA has given us a path to the future of human coding. There is a path, there is a future. And we're going to be talking about it in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe.